dad was named Dewey. He was born in 1898. My mother's name is Alice. She was born 2 years later in 1900. There were five kids in the family. I was the fourth, and they were both, my mother was born in Ohio, my father was born in Kentucky, and they were married in 1960. My mother was only 16 years old. When you say after they married, they lived in several different places, in Middletown or in around Middletown, Ohio for the most part, but I was born in Kentucky.
What job did they have?
Well, when we lived in Kentucky, he worked in coal mines. And then he farmed. He worked for the R&R Tobacco Company for about 25 years. He worked for the city of Middletown and retired from there. And my mother was just my mother was a homemaker. She worked at home, taking care of kids.
When did they die?
My mother died in 1959. And my father died in 1970. Remember everything about them. They were loving parents. We didn't have a whole lot, but they did the best they could with what they had. With a big family, you know what I mean? It was kind of nip and tuck. In those days, especially before the war, and there wasn't a lot of money to be spent, so we spent, and it was kind of tough going. I guess we was poor, but I didn't know we was poor because everybody else was in the same boat. When I was 13, the war, World War II, was over just a little bit before that. I was a young man when World War II was going on. They dropped the atomic bomb, and the first atomic bomb in that era. Historic. in my lifetime, a lot of things, but that's the most prominent thing at that period in time. The war was over, and it was over because they dropped the atomic bomb, and everybody surrendered that way.
What was life like when you were 13?
Well, it was a rural life. We lived in the country. It was farming. And I just got electricity, by the way. That made it nicer. It was pretty good. I was a happy kid. Didn't have anything, but I was happy as a kid.
What fun things do you remember?
Mainly outdoor activities. You know, I like to run the creeks. I like hunting, fishing. I like raising chicken. Making things, slingshots, the rubber bands, the dart guns, the tapioca, the bean shooters, and all that kind of stuff. There's a lot of fun things.
What bad things do you remember?
Sickness. We didn't have the medicines those days that we have today, and didn't have the medical care. And I remember kids dying of polio, scarlet fever, diphtheria, things like that we couldn't control then. So I guess the bad things were we didn't have running water, inside plumbing, and that sort of thing, you know. So, but mainly health conditions.
Who was president?
When I was 13?
Yeah.
Harry Truman.
Did you like him?
Yeah. The news media at the time was really knocking him. I always liked him. I liked him because he was faithful and he said what he thought. And of course, one thing and another, but I really enjoyed him. And now, historians say he's probably one of the greatest presidents we ever had.
What things were most kids worried about?
Worried about anything. I mean, that's I don't think we had time to worry. We had a lot of chores. maybe getting home in time to do the milking. I don't know. I didn't have any worries, any really.
Did you help out at home?
Oh yeah. Everybody had chores. We had certain things we had to do every day.
Did you know what you wanted to be in life?
No.
Had you met Grandma when you were 13?
No. Normally, home entertainment in the daytime was outside activities as far as being on creeks. Like I said, making things, slingshots, we had the Hoover traps that I would catch rabbits in and that sort of thing, you know. But at nighttime entertainment was, once in a while Dad had a battery-operated radio. And we'd get to listen to Captain Midnight or, you know, maybe sitting around the fireplace, we'd play rubbing clothespins in a bottle or in a bottle, things like that. Haircuts. Some of them had mohawk haircuts, but haircuts was different style haircuts were fads. Bobby socks for the girls. Rolled up t-shirts for the guys was and blue jeans rolled up, and that was fads.
What did kids wear if they wanted to be in or cool?
Probably saddle Oxford shoes, white socks, turned down, pleated skirts for the girls. And probably gabardine pants for the boys, you know, that sort of thing. But it was and turned up shirts. That, yeah, that was a fad.
And did your family have a car?
Later, but not then. When I was about 15, we got a car.
Where did you live at the time?
Lived in West Middletown.
Did you have your own room?
No. I had to share with my brother.
What was your room like? Or did you decorate it?
No money to decorate it. It was our job to keep it clean, but it was drab. No, nothing like that. I'm sitting here in your room now. I see the stuffed toys and frills on your bedspread and fancy curtains. No, I didn't have anything. It was not. It was a place to sleep and that's about it.
Sports were popular?
Well, that's the one thing that made me fit in probably a lot better than I did in grade school, because I guess I was fairly active in sports. I played football, we had tennis, track, basketball. We didn't have, in those days, we didn't have soccer. We had baseball, but we didn't have any soccer. They're pretty much the same thing as it was today, but we didn't have wrestling. We didn't have gyms to wrestle in either. We didn't have gymnasiums to do this in. Everything had to be outside. So.
What radio show did you like most?
Captain Midnight.
What was the show about?
It was a fantasy type thing. An Inner Sanctum that you probably don't remember, or a Batman type thing. You know, it was a good man versus evil. And of course, he always come out on top. He was always victorious.
Some
of the popular movies there? Betty Davis. And mostly when I was a young man, you know, it was Western things. Roy Rogers, Johnny McBrown. But, you know, there were other good, the Barry Moore family was extremely popular in movies. You know, they had two boys and a girl in their family. They were Lionel Barrymore. I forget their name. Ethel Barrymore was a crazy one. They were good actors and actresses, their whole family. But I was mainly interested in westerns and outdoor movies. So it was the cowboys that sent them, but I liked it.
What type of books did you read?
I like history and I like science. So most of it was science books that I read. I mean, I like to read them better. I was required to read literature and poems and that sort of thing, but I love to read them.
What were your most valuable possessions?
think maybe a 22 rifle.
What is your most valid memory from that time?
Probably just like it is today, this Thanksgiving today, and probably family get-togethers, meals, for Christmas and Thanksgiving and Easter and what have you. I think it was kind of the Walton concept. Just to get a type thing with the memory that I had more than anything else. I got run over with the combine, just 13 years old, and that sticks in my mind about it. Hey,
that's all.
That's it.
Yep.